Clip one, we have some A-Ram footage with Cho'Gath landing a five-person rupture, followed by a Yasuo last breath and then a Zyra ultimate, leading to a triple for Zyra and an ace for the red team. Clip two, an unconventional way to escape the enemy base. Next, we have what looks like a normal dragon attempt with Sylas jumping through the wall. The blue team looks for sure to be in place to take this dragon, but Warwick making an appearance only just for a brief second before running away. Ultimately, though, it's all that was needed as Warwick steals the dragon. Next up, we have the red team Kayn going for the enemy blue buff, but getting surrounded by the enemy Xerath and Singe as the ward spots him out. Dropped in extremely low, he will be able to gain some health back before going through the wall and making his way towards the river. Running into the enemy Singe, though, he's able to dodge the Xerath Q with his dash as he's flung back by Singe. He will then ult Singe, noticing his friendly Alawi as he jumps through the wall. He will blast cone away, Singe in hot pursuit, though, with that speed buff, but Kayn dashing through the wall, attacking the Gromp, running into the enemy Nunu. Now, still staying in the wall as he's smited by Nunu. He will land the knockup. Nunu going for the snowball as Kayn notices this. He will go through the wall once again with the dash. Now getting some help from his friendly Yasuo. He will head right towards the enemy Jhin though. As he dodges another Xerath Q and the Xerath stun, making his way towards the wall. He will dash through, avoiding everything from Jhin as he's dropped low by Nunu. He will be able to gain some much needed health back as his team arrives and helps him out, allowing him to escape safely. Next, we have a gank going for Azir in the middle lane. Lee Sin coming from the river, missing the Sonic Wave. He will lay some damage out as Vladimir follows after. Lee Sin will ward hop and Vlad will flash. In the process, though, Azir is going to misclick using his teleport on his turret. In the end, it's not going to matter as he picks up the flashy first blood. Next, we have a confident blue team going for the dive, taking the kill on Zed, leaving a lonesome Hecarim 1v5 on his own turret. Hecarim, though, with his ability to gain some health back and his skillful outplays with the help of the turret, will manage a double kill right away. He then charging at Gragas, and with the help of the turret again will take the triple on Lucian and the quadra on the Gragas. Now we have one guy left, Bard, as Hecarim chases, who will dodge the Q just barely and then charge through the ultimate, finishing off Bard for the pentakill. Next, we have a typical top lane scrum, Malphite versus Urgot. Urgot, knowing Malphite has his ultimate, is going to play a little sly trick here. As Malphite comes from the bush with the unstoppable force, Urgot will be able to avoid it with the flash and then dunk Malphite on the turret. And with the help of that turret, take the easy kill. Moving along to a Baron fight with the blue team going for the Baron, Jarvan will finish off the red buff before heading to investigate. He has a friendly Ahri by his side as Jarvan throws down the standard. Ahri is going to approach from the Baron pit. Jarvan will notice this and go in with her as he slams down the Cataclysm on the enemy Heimer for kill number one, before moving to Vi for kill number two and then finishing off what's left of the Baron. Now Jarvan in a 1v2 situation as Fiddle falls, now having the triple kill. The enemy team trying to finish him off, the Kate ult going up, but Jarvan will be able to finish her off before it can connect, and with the help of his friendly Thresh, Jarvan will be able to finish off what's remaining of the enemy Sion for the official pentakill and the Baron steal. Now we have a Blitz duel at level 1 with Blitz on the outside of the blue buff, noticing the red team going for that blue. He will approach and throw out the hook on the blue, but the friendly Blitz, the red team Blitz, is going to have none of that as he prevents it, allowing his friendly Kha'Zix to finish it off and take it from the enemy team. Next up, we have Kayn in the middle lane getting collapsed upon by the enemy Irelia, though getting trapped as she throws on the ultimate. It's not going to be enough as Caitlyn finishes her off for the kill. Not quite out of the woods yet as the enemy Master Yi approaches with the ultimate, and then the Alpha Strike. Caitlyn will be able to force the meditate though as Triss jumps over the wall trying to finish what Irelia started, but Caitlyn with that damage will be able to land crit after crit and take the triple kill. Next up, we have Ezreal going for the Elder Dragon as he throws out the True Shot Barrage, having a hunch that the enemy team is doing Baron. It will steal it from the enemy team. Not only does he get Baron, but he will be able to finish off what's remaining of the Elder for the double objective. In the same vein as our first clip, we have Malphite and his friendly Yasuo and Xayah. The enemy team taking the double. Katarina takes the double in the river. Malphite noticing that the enemy team is in that river, assuming that they're going for Baron, he will make his way towards the pit. The enemy team will take the Baron, but as they come out of the pit, they're going to be met by a surprise as Malphite lands a five-person unstoppable force, followed by the Yasuo Last Breath and the Xayah ultimate. As five members of the enemy team were standing at one point, they are no longer as Malphite and his teammates take the ace. Next up, we have a good old-fashioned Thresh God play as Lee Sin coming for the gank, getting flayed and then ulted. He's not going to stand a chance as he's exhausted as well. He will go down, giving the kill to Kai'Sa. Thresh then landing the hook and then the flay on Lux. Lux will ultimately go down for the double kill. Ezreal will take a couple of shots before retreating back to the turret. He's not going to retreat back completely, though, which in the end will be his downfall as Thresh is not done yet. He will make his way towards the enemy Ezreal, predicting a arcane shift, and that's exactly what's going to happen as he arcane shifts right into the Thresh hook. He will flay and in the end up going down, giving the unofficial triple to Kai'Sa. Today's last play is something that doesn't happen very often, an Ornn play, as Ornn getting jumped by Aatrox on his turret. Ornn is going to summon out his ram. As he heads towards his ram, he will flash ahead and then get the huge knockup on Aatrox with a kill. Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Top Plays and Fails. This is a new collaboration between myself and Fizz Khalifa. I do hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, I would appreciate a thumbs up and a comment down below letting me know what your favorite play was. And if you have any suggestions for future episodes of this series or other videos you would like to see, make sure to drop those as well. My name is Chris, aka Jump in a Pack. Thanks again for watching, and I will talk to you guys next time. Phenomenon, rapping to the beat.